Good morning, children. In our previous class, we had learned Dalton's atomic theory. Hope that you have learned that theory. Today, we are going to learn about atomic mass unit. After that, we will learn what is a molecule, molecule of an element, and molecule of a compound.
Atomic mass unit, it is written as U. In our previous class, we had learned Dalton's atomic theory. According to Dalton, each element had a characteristic atomic mass. Dalton's atomic theory could explain the law of constant proportions so well that scientists were prompted to measure the atomic mass of an atom. Since determining the mass of an individual atom was a relatively difficult task, relative atomic masses were determined using the laws of chemical combinations. While searching for various atomic mass units, scientists initially took 1/16 of the mass of an atom of naturally occurring oxygen as the unit. This was considered relevant due to two reasons. The first reason is oxygen reacted with a large number of elements and formed compounds. The second reason is this atomic mass unit gave masses of most of the elements as whole numbers. However, in 1961, carbon-12 isotope was chosen as the standard reference for measuring atomic masses. Then what is one atomic mass unit? One atomic mass unit is a mass unit equal to exactly 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon-12. Consider this as an atom of carbon-12. Carbon-12 means mass of that carbon is 12. If we divide this carbon-12 atom into 12 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, then this part is the 1/12 of this carbon atom, isn't it? And this 1/12 part is 1U. Clear? If we take these two parts together, then that is 2U. This 3, 3U. Then 4U, 5, 6. And this part is 6U. That means half of this carbon, mass of half of this carbon is 6U. Clear? So one atomic mass unit is mass unit equal to exactly 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon-12. Mass of hydrogen is 1U. That means only this part. Mass of carbon is 12U. Mass of nitrogen is 14U. That means nitrogen atom is bigger than carbon atom. Mass of nitrogen is higher than that of carbon. Mass of oxygen is 16U. Clear? So one atomic mass unit is a mass unit exactly 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon-12. Now you know the term atom. What is an atom? Yes, atom is the smallest particle of a substance or a matter. Then what is a molecule? two or more atoms combine together to form a molecule, or it can be defined as the smallest particle of an element or a compound that is capable of an independent existence and shows all the properties of that substance. Then, what is molecule of an element? The molecules of an element are constituted by the same type of atoms. That means, molecule of an element consists of same type of atom. That is hydrogen molecule, oxygen molecule, nitrogen molecule, chlorine molecule, phosphorus molecule, etc. It contains same type of atoms. Molecules of many elements such as argon, that is air, helium, Hg, etc. are made up of only one atom of that element. And that type of molecule is called monoatomic molecule. So monoatomic molecule means it contains only one atom. And that one atom is enough to show all the properties of that substance, and that one atom has independent existence. So this air means argon molecule, not argon atom. Clear? Helium. Helium molecule is Hg. That means that single atom has independent existence and it shows all the properties of that substance. So air is argon molecule, Hg is helium molecule. So these two are monoatomic molecules. The number of atoms constituting a molecule is known as its atomicity. So the atomicity of this argon or helium is 1. Clear? But an oxygen molecule is formed by the combination of 2 oxygen atoms. Molecule of oxygen consists of 2 atoms of oxygen, and hence it is known as diatomic molecule. Oxygen, hydrogen, etc. are diatomic molecules. That means that molecules are formed by the combination of 2 atoms. Clear? Phosphorus molecule is P4. 4 phosphorus atoms combine together to form phosphorus molecule. So it is called tetraatomic molecule. In the case of sulfur, 8 sulfur atoms combine together to form sulfur molecule, and that molecule is called polyatomic molecules. So if 4 or more atoms combine together to form a molecule, then they are called polyatomic molecule. Clear? So phosphorus is an example for tetraatomic molecule. Sulfur is an example for polyatomic molecule. Then what is the atomicity of this oxygen? Yes, 2 is the atomicity of that oxygen molecule. Why? Because 2 atoms combine together to form an oxygen molecule. So argon, helium, etc. are examples of monoatomic molecule. Oxygen, hydrogen, etc. are examples for diatomic molecule. Example for a tetraatomic molecule is phosphorus. Example for a polyatomic molecule is sulfur. Clear? Molecules of compounds. Atoms of different elements join together in definite proportions to form molecules of compounds. Examples: H2O. H2O is water molecule. H2O is a compound. This shows a molecule of water. Then CO2, as carbon dioxide molecule. CO is carbon monoxide molecule. CuSO4 is copper sulfate molecule. This copper sulfate consists of copper atom, sulfur atom, and oxygen atom. So copper, sulfur, and oxygen combine together to form this compound copper sulfate. Can you say the difference between 2H and 2H2? This H stands for hydrogen atom. Then 2H means two hydrogen atoms. Then what is 2H2? H2 means a molecule of hydrogen. Then 2H2 means two molecules of hydrogen. Then what is the difference between O2 and 3O2? Yes, O2 means one oxygen molecule. 3O2 means three oxygen molecule. Then what is the difference between O3 and O2? O3 is ozone. It is a molecule of ozone. So O3 means ozone molecule and O2 means oxygen molecule. One oxygen molecule. Clear? Then what is the difference between H2O and 2H2O? H2O means, yes, one molecule of water. This is a molecule of a compound. So 1H2O means one water molecule. Then what is 2H2O? Yes, it means two molecules of water. Clear?
That's all for today. Hope that you have understood the topic atomic mass unit and molecule. You should revise what we have learned today and refer your textbook also. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you.